Where are you there tonight? Raise up your hand. And then raise your voice to the Lord. And say, Lord, I'm here tonight. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. Say it with your mouth. He wants to bless you. He wants to turn your life around. He wants to do something unforgettable. Something incredible. Something almost unbelievable. He wants to do it in your life. You tell the Lord, say it. And say it with faith. And believe tonight. And the Lord will roll those mountains away. You will never be the same again. Tell the Lord, tell the Lord, tell him what you want. Tell him you are here. You want to connect with the Almighty. You want to connect with his power. Nothing impossible for the Lord. He's here tonight to bless you. And you are here tonight to receive. He cannot fail. He will not fail. His power will roll all the mountains of your life away. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody shout amen. Our Father, we thank you tonight. We know that you are the God of wonders, the God of power. With you tonight, we know that all things are possible. You are the God who has not changed. Because you remain forever the same. Your law is still the same. Your power is still the same. Your wonders still the same. Your promises still the same. And with you, we have the confidence and the faith. Now, whatever you've done in the past, you are able to do today. Lord Jesus, we thank you because we know you are here. According to your promise, where two or three are gathered in your name, you are there in their midst. And we know you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. Glorify yourself in every life tonight in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost, Spirit of the Living God, the power of heaven in the church. We're asking, Lord, that you roll mountains away today in Jesus' name. The supernatural signs will follow us tonight. Touch every life. Turn our lives around. Transform everyone. We thank you because we know you have answered. Do wonders in every life. Thank you, Lord, for the answer. In Jesus' name we pray. Sinner and the blessing of the Lord. Tonight, as you understand, we come because we know God has promised something. He has promised you in particular showers of blessing. He's promised your family. He's promised your community. He's promised our state. He's promised everyone that is here tonight. Showers of blessing. I think you've heard that before. We've sung it in our singing. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. Mercy drops around us are falling. But for the showers we plead. Did you know that that is in the Bible? That God promised us the showers in the Bible. And every word of God is fulfilled. When you come, you hear that word. You understand that word. You look at that word, you expound that word to yourself. That's what he said. He said it. I believe it. And because of that, I know it's done. I'm coming to Ezekiel chapter 34. Ezekiel chapter 34. And I'm reading from verse 26. And you'll see how the Lord himself gives us the promise. In Ezekiel chapter 34 verse 26. It says, and I will make them and the places round about my heel a blessing. That's the Almighty God talking. That's the one that cannot fail talking. That's the Creator Redeemer talking to us. That's the source of all blessings talking to us. It comes with salvation. It comes with blessing. It comes with healing. It comes with deliverance. It comes with a turning around in your life. And it says, I will. I'm sure you understand when a mighty man says, I will, even in our world. A puny person, a pygmy cannot come and say, no, you cannot. And when God says, I will, there is not a devil from the pit of hell that can say, no, you cannot. There's no Satan that can say, no, you cannot. There's no demon that can say, no, you cannot. When God says, I will, there is no power of darkness that can say, no, you cannot. Your life tonight, the Lord is saying, I will. In your family tonight, the Lord is saying, I will. He's going to do something he has decided. He says, and I will make them and the places round about my heel a blessing. Look at this, and I will cause the shower to come down in his season. I will cause the shower to come down in a season. And then it says, at the end of that verse, it says, there shall be showers of blessing. Upon your life tonight, there shall be showers of blessing. Your family tonight, there will be showers of blessing. I'm talking to you on the appointed season of the latter rain. The appointed season of the latter rain. What do you see from the passages of scripture I read to you? That is the time of the latter rain. It's the time of showers of blessing. It's the time of God to rain down the supernatural from heaven upon your life. The season, the time, the period, this is the era, and it is the appointed season of the latter rain. And so you cannot say, well, I remain dry, I remain weary, I remain sinful, I remain sick, I remain tired, I remain hopeless, I remain helpless. The time has come. The time has come for the change in your life. It will happen to you. The appointed season, your own appointed season of the latter rain. Three things I'm looking at. Number one is the announcement of the latter rain. That's the promise of the latter rain. The Almighty God from heaven has announced. He said, the time has come. The time of the latter rain. He gives you the announcement. He says, get ready to come out of the weariness of your life. Get ready to come out of the dryness of your life. Get ready to come out of the desert. Get ready to come out of that wilderness. Because as an announcement is reaching us from heaven, the announcement of the latter rain, the promise of the latter rain, this rain will fall tonight. Number two, the agony of the lost rain. The agony of the lost rain. When rain is lost, what can the farmers do? When rain is lost, what can the populace do? There is agony. There is drought. There is famine. There is sickness. There is contagious disease. Everybody is tired. Everybody is sweating. There is the agony of the lost rain. When there is no refreshing in your life, when there is no revival in your life, when you are pushing life and life is pushing you, when you are dragging life and life is dragging you, when it appears that there's nothing working in the farm, there's nothing working in the home, there's nothing working in your spiritual life, there's nothing working in your religious life, there's nothing working prayer, there's nothing working in your fast, there's nothing working, and it appears there's no rain from heaven. Lost rain, the agony, the pain that comes as a result of that. But thank God, all that agony in your life, all the affliction in your life, all the suffering in your life, tonight is the night to roll everything away. If you believe that, say good amen. Number one is the announcement of the latter rain. Number two is the agony of the lost rain. Number three is the abundance of the Lord's rain. This is not a rain from man. This coming from the Lord himself. The Lord of glory. The Lord of power. The Lord of promise. The Lord that never fails. Is his rain. The showers coming from the Lord himself. The blessing coming from the Lord himself. And the outflow, the outpouring coming from the Lord himself. And he says, I'll pour it down. He says, I'll put it on you. He says, I'll shower it on you. He says, you will possess it. And he says, all the weariness will vanish away. He says, all the evil things will vanish away. Number one, he's giving us the announcement. He's saying that tonight something is going to happen. I said, tonight over there something is going to happen. This one is going to touch your life. It will be poured upon you mightily today. A flood of blessings. A flood of eternal riches. God brings upon your life today. The announcement. The announcement. The proclamation of that latter rain. Deuteronomy chapter 11. Deuteronomy chapter 11. And there's something wonderful here. When that rain comes, not the natural rain, the supernatural rain. When that rain comes, not the natural rain, the spiritual rain. When that rain comes, not the normal rain, but the special, specific, unique rain coming upon your life. It tells us in Deuteronomy chapter 11, it says in verse 13, it says, and it shall come to pass. Tonight it will come to pass. Tonight it will happen. The blessings of God coming upon you today. And it shall come to pass. If ye shall hearken diligently unto my commandments, which I command you this day, to love the Lord your God, and to serve him with all your heart, and with all your soul. It says, if you come to this side of the Lord, Satan is over there on one side. God is there on the other side. Satan the destroyer is there on the other side. And God the creator is on the other side here. Satan, the one of darkness, angel of darkness is over there. And God the almighty and the source of light is on the other side. And he says, you make up your mind. If you're going to follow Satan, then there's going to be calamity.
He says,
but if you hearken to my word, if you listen to me tonight, and then you say, I'm on the Lord's side, and I leave Satan's side, I leave the side of darkness, I leave idolatry, I leave defilement, I leave all abominations, and I cross over, I make up my mind tonight, and I decide, I come to the side of the Lord.
He says,
if you listen, if you take action, if you move, if you come out of darkness and you come to the light, if you come away from the devil and you come to the God who is our creator, look at what it says in verse 14. It says, then I will give you the rain of your land in the season. It says in due season, and this is that season. It says, once you cross over to the Lord, somebody is crossing over to the Lord there today. I said, somebody is crossing over to the Lord today. There'll be forgiveness.
He'll
forgive all your sins. There'll be fruitfulness. You become fruitful in your life. There'll be freedom. It will set you free. I said it will set you free. Favor will come from heaven. Because everything you didn't have before, remember, when there's no rain, when we're sinning, we have guilt and condemnation, and we have oppression, and we have darkness and confusion. But now you make up your mind, because it says, if you will now love the Lord with all your heart, all your soul, if you are not dividing yourself into two, a part of you comes to the Lord on Sunday, and the rest part of your life stays with Satan for the rest of the week. He says, if you are not dividing yourself, you say you come with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, every day, Sunday or weekday, I'm going to be for the Lord totally with all my heart, with all my soul. I give myself to the Lord. I will follow Christ. I will live with Christ. I will lean on Christ. I'm going to abide in Christ. Then he says, once you make up your mind, somebody is making up his mind right there now. I said, somebody is making up their mind right there. It says, then I will give you rain of your land in its due time. The first rain and the latter rain. That thou mayest gather in the corn. It says it's going to so bless you that all the things that are scattered in your life will be gathered together. I used to hear good amen. And look at what will follow. When that latter rain comes today, the announcement that God himself is making, that when we turn unto him with all our hearts, with all our soul, with all our mind, and we follow the Lord without reservation. Look at verse 21. That your days may be multiplied.
You
see what the latter rain does? That your days may be multiplied. Premature death will stop in your life. Will stop in your family. And those life-threatening diseases, everything will vanish away. That your days may be multiplied. And the days of your children, God will bless your children. God will bless your offspring. God will bless the citizens of this state in Jesus' name. In the land which the Lord swore to your fathers to give them. Listen to the last line there. The time of the latter rain. Look at the result there in the last line. And the time of the showers of blessing. Look at the result there in the last line. As the days of heaven upon the earth. That's God making announcement. That's the proclamation of the Lord himself. He said, for you, it will be as the days of heaven upon the earth. There's no sin in heaven, sin will get out of your life. There's no sickness in heaven, sickness will get out of your life. Evil spirits are not in heaven, all the powers of darkness will get out of your life. There's no oppression in heaven, oppression will get out of your life. Blessing. Blessing as the days of heaven upon the earth. Look at Joel chapter 2. The latter rain. The announcement of the latter rain. The proclamation of the latter rain. The goodness of God upon your life in the latter rain. The fullness of his outpouring in the latter rain. The latter rain that God promised, he promised to everyone, every single person in his kingdom. You come out of the kingdom of darkness and you come into the kingdom of light. I see you coming. I see you coming. You're making up your mind. I will serve the Lord. I see you coming. I will serve the Lord. Are you the person I'm talking about? You will serve the Lord. I said you will serve the Lord. Idols, bye bye forever. Sin, bye bye forever. Crime, bye bye forever. Thanks, bye bye forever. All the stealing, bye bye forever. And those dirty habits, bye bye forever. Give me a good amen there now. Then in Joel chapter 2, reading from verse 23, he says, be glad then. If you're coming out of your darkness, be glad then. If you're coming out of that wilderness, be glad then. Be glad then, you children of Zion. Rejoice in the Lord your God. For he has given you the former rain moderately, and it will cause to come down for you the rain. The former rain and the latter rain in the first month. Look at this in verse 25. And I will restore unto you the years that the locusts have eaten. That's the announcement of the Lord. It says, I look at your life and I look at every good thing you have lost. I'm going to restore unto you every good thing you have lost in your life. Your family, he'll restore the family. Children, he'll restore the children. And your good life, he'll restore the good life. Your freedom, he'll restore the freedom. It says, and I will restore to you the years that the locusts have eaten. All that the evil spirits have stolen from your life. All that the evil powers have eaten from your life. All the devouring beasts that have come to your life, everything will vanish away. It's the announcement of the latter rain. It says, showers are coming. Showers are coming there. I said showers are coming there. Coming upon your life. It tells us in that verse 25. All that the cankerworm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, the great army which I sent among you, he said everything will vanish away. Verse 26. And ye shall eat in plenty and be satisfied. Joy will come in fullness once again. Satisfaction will come once again. Suicide will stop in your family. What do people commit suicide? I'm fed up. Nobody loves me. I don't even love anybody.
Too.
I'm fed up. Things are hard. I turn here. There's problem. I turn there. There's disaster. I turn there. There's calamity. I turn there. Hopelessness everywhere. They say, what am I doing here? Dissatisfaction of your life will vanish away tonight. It will satisfy your life with joy. Your family, you'll see your husband, there'll be joy. You'll see your wife, there'll be joy. You'll see your children, your parents, there'll be joy. You go to the place of work. You used to go to the place of work. When you're going in the morning, your heart is beating. I don't know what I'm going to meet today. It will turn your enemies to become your friends. In the community, you used to sneak into your house when you're coming. I don't want them to see me. Once they see me, I have bad dreams, I have this, I have that. That's why your life is like lost life. But thank God for tonight. Somebody there said, thank God tonight. Satisfaction will come to you in Jesus' name. He tells us in the verse 26, and praise the name of the Lord your God, that has dealt wondrously with you. Tonight, wonders will come to your life. It's the announcement of the latter rain. It's the proclamation of the latter rain. It's the showers he wants to bring upon your life today. And this is wonderful. The last line of verse 26, this is wonderful. I said, this is wonderful. Somebody help me shout wonderful. And my people shall never be ashamed. The reproach of your life, it will take away. The problems of your life, it will take away. All those tears, it will wipe away. And my people shall never, never, never be ashamed. And you shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I am the Lord your God, and none else. And again, my people shall never be ashamed. Look at verse 32. And it shall come to pass. It's coming to pass in your life today. And it shall come to pass. I rejoice with you. I congratulate you. Because it will come to pass in your life tonight. And it shall come to pass that whosoever, 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 who is the whosoever? I said whosoever. Who is the whosoever? What's his name? Whosoever. I said, what's his name? I can't hear the name. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. Final.
Okay.
Salvation has come. Final. Healing has come. Final. Deliverance has come. Did you hear the announcement of the latter rain? Why is it to remain in the agony of the lost rain? Let me show you briefly the people that are living in the wilderness. If you have heard about the wilderness before, the children of Israel lived in the wilderness. Every day there was something to grumble about. Every time there was something to murmur about. Every moment there was something to complain about. As though there was no joy, there was no peace, there was no unity, there was no faith. They were living in darkness, and they were walking, and life was weary for them. Discouragement came to them. Disappointment came to them. They didn't experience the rain. And the Lord was telling them, you're passing through your own man-made wilderness. Apart from the normal wilderness, you make your own life weary and dreary. You cause your own sorrow. The agony of the lost rain. When people have lost the rain, it happened in the land of Israel. No rain, no joy, no peace, no satisfaction, no fulfillment. Everything was there to make them happy. Everything was there to make them blessed. But of their own making, they made their lives to be the life of agony and the life of suffering. How did that happen? How could that happen to them? Look at Jeremiah chapter 3. I'm reading here from verse 3. Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 3. It tells us in chapter 3, verse 3. And it's telling, it was telling the children of Israel, also telling you. It says, therefore, the showers have been withholding. It says, therefore, it's been talking about their lives, their attitude, their crimes, their sins, their transgression. He said, I'm surprised that you have a lot of good things waiting for you, and yet you choose to remain in your sin. He said, therefore, the showers have been withholding. There has been no latter rain. He said, I know the announcement I made. I know the proclamation I made. I know the blessing I wanted to give you. I know the declaration of the showers of blessing. But look at this. The latter rain is withholding. And thou hast a worse hair, forehead. He said, they were stubborn in their abomination. They were rigid in their wickedness. He said, they were sold to crime. He said, because of that, all the rain I wanted to bring on you, I couldn't. But tonight, something will change over there. I said, tonight, something will change over there. He said, thou refused to be ashamed. Can you think of a lady into prostitution and she's not ashamed? Can you think of somebody doing criminal things that will lead him to the prison and then is bold faced and is not ashamed? Can you think about a person that is doing something dirty, something defiling, something abominable, and everybody is saying, how could you do this? How could you do this? And the fellow just has a kind of a stony face and is not ashamed. And then the Lord is saying, that's why the rain is withholding from you. Now he says in verse 4, we can turn this thing around. Your life can turn around tonight. I said your life will turn around tonight. All this is, you have been in a seat when I can do whatever I want to do. And calamities in your life, sickness in your life, all the problems are overshadowing your life. Your talent and your ability you cannot express. And you are the hindrance to your own joy. Because of that kind of rigidity in evil. It says in verse 4. Look at verse 4. Will thou not from this time cry unto me, my father, thou art the guide of my youth? After he has told us that he has withheld the latter rain and the showers are not coming down because of refusing to turn around, oh, he says, but the door of mercy is not closed. I can open the door for you. The door to the latter rain is not closed. I can open the door for you. And the announcement of the latter rain has not been cancelled. Only you will come and cry unto the Lord and say, my Father, my Creator, my Redeemer, the one that will bless me, I return to you. You are returning tonight. I said you are returning tonight. And as you return, you return out of that darkness, out of that evil. The door will just open to you wide. The door of blessing. The door of miracle. It will happen to you tonight. That door will open in Jesus' name. Look at Jeremiah chapter 5 verse 24. Jeremiah chapter 5 verse 24. Neither say they in their hearts. It's they're forgetful. They forget the announcement. They forget the proclamation. They forget the promise. They forget the open doors. They forget that I am the one that will bless them. Neither say they in their hearts, let us now fear the Lord our God, that giveth rain both the former and the latter in his season, and he reserveth unto us the appointed weeks of the harvest. He said, they're not even recognizing me in their hearts. They go to their alcohol, and alcohol is the master. They go to their fetishes, and their fetishes are their masters. They don't have any remembrance of me. And neither do they say, that's our God. That made the announcement. That made the proclamation. That said, I'm going to give you the latter rain. Look at verse 25. He said, your iniquities have turned away. These things, the things I could have done for you, the peace I could have given you, the joy I could have given you, the life I would have given you, the satisfaction I would have given you, the pleasure I would have given you, and the resources of heaven I could have brought upon your life. They're still watching. He says, your iniquities have turned away these things, and your sins have withholding good things from you. Some people say, well, if that is my, this is what God wants for me. Sickness, calamity, bondage, problem, no progress, enemy, darkness, bad dreams. If that is my predestination, if that is what God has chosen for me, he said, no, I'm not choosing that for you. You chose that for yourself. Your iniquities, your sins, your crime, your bad behavior, your immoral life, your idol worship, all those things I was told you good things from you. He says, but now you will change. Now you will turn around. Now you will call on the name of the Lord. Now you will say, since the opportunity is still there, I'm going to have the blessing of the Lord. Somebody there tonight is reconnecting with the blessing of the Lord. Somebody there tonight, where are you? Praise the Lord, you'll reconnect. I said you'll reconnect. Light will come to your life. Salvation will come to you there. Forgiveness will come to you there. Fruitfulness will come to you there. The favor of heaven will come upon your life. Once you make up your mind, Lord, I realize and I turn and I repent and I hold on to Jesus, my Savior tonight. Something beautifully wonderful will happen to you. The Lord himself is saying, okay, turn to me and I will turn to you. Call upon me and I will answer you. Ask Ask for all the blessings that you have lost.
We're
coming back to Zechariah chapter 10 verse 1. Zechariah chapter 10 verse 1. It says, ask ye of the Lord. Don't ask of an idol. Ask ye of the Lord. Don't ask of occultism. Ask ye of the Lord. Don't ask from a mere man that puts himself almost as God. Ask ye of the Lord. Don't go to the shrine of the devil to ask. He doesn't have salvation. He doesn't have redemption. He doesn't have deliverance. Only God has that salvation.
There's
no other name given among men whereby we can be saved. It's the name of Jesus. Ask ye of the Lord. Somebody is asking tonight. Ask ye of the Lord in the time of the latter rain. So the Lord shall make bright clouds and give them showers of rain to everyone, grass in the field. It's happening to you tonight. But you will ask. Hosea chapter 10. Hosea chapter 10. I'm reading from verse 12. It says, sow to yourself in righteousness.
You'll
be sowing wickedness, dig that up and burn it up. We sow into occultism, dig it up and burn it up. All the covenants were powers of darkness. Take that away from your life and say, I come to God, the mighty God, the powerful God, the God of light. I get away from the God of darkness. He says, sow to yourself in righteousness. All those evil ways, dig them up and throw them away. And now repent of all your sins. Sow to yourself in righteousness and reap in mercy and break up your fallow ground. That heart that is hard, you can injure another person. Your heart will not feel any kind of guilt. It says that you break up your fallow ground. That's saying that I will do what I will do. I don't feel guilty. I don't feel condemned. I say what I want to say. I go where I want to go. I can abuse and insult anybody. I can demolish, destroy anything. And I'm ready for another kind of season of destruction. He said, blessings don't come that way. He says, you break up your fallow ground. For it is time to seek the Lord. It is time to seek the Lord. Somebody there is seeking the Lord today. I said somebody there is seeking the Lord today. It is time to seek the Lord until he come and rain righteousness upon you. The abundance of the Lord's rain. There's a time among the children of Israel. There was no rain. For 3 years, people were dying. People were suffering. There was nothing to eat. The farms were not bringing up anything. There was no joy in the land. All the blessings of the Lord, they had promised, nothing was there. And Elijah then came to them. And he asked them a question. And he said, how halt ye between two opinions? If the Lord be Lord, then serve him. If the Lord be our God, serve him. If it's Baal, serve him. The Bible says their mouths were short. Guilt shut their mouth. Condemnation shut their mouth. Their own sins shut their mouth. They couldn't answer him a word. And so Elijah said, all right now, let's see who is the true God. He said, all these worshippers of Baal, let him dress. Let them dress the altar. Make the altar. Address his sacrifice. Let them call to their God Baal, the God that brings fire, that God will serve. And the people said, that's right, you've said well. All those followers of the false God, they cried and cried and cried. And there was nothing. So Elijah came and said, get aside. He repaired the altar of the Lord. The altar of the Lord in your heart is being repaired right now. You're making up your mind, I'm going the right direction. I'm going to serve the Lord. All those wasted years of serving the devil, everything was stopped tonight. And then he told them to pour water around the trenches. And then he said, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, let these people know that you have turned their hearts again. And the fire came down upon the altar. Fire of revival is coming down today. The fire of repentance is coming down today. The fire of renewal is coming down today. And then after that, they took away all the prophets of Baal. Those were the hindrances to the announcement of the latter rain. And now the Lord was able to bring the rain. And so they got rid of anything that will hinder the rain. And then Elijah told Ahab, he said, get ready, there's a sound of the abundance of rain. I'm telling you tonight now, there's a sound of the abundance of rain. It's coming upon your life right there. And then he prayed. And he told the servant to go and check up. And the servant came back. I said, I see nothing. You didn't look very well. I'm going to tell you to check up tonight. Check up those blinders, they'll be open. You say, Pastor, I didn't see anything. You didn't check up very well. Then he sent him the second time. He came back and said, I see nothing. You must see something. Somebody there, you'll see something tonight. Somebody there, you'll see miracle tonight. Somebody there, the rain will fall tonight. And then he came back the seventh time. Said, Prophet, I see. I see. The cloud like a man's hand. He said, that's enough. That little feeling that you have, that little evidence you have, that little change you have, I see. And then he said, go tell Ahab, before a few minutes, the rain came down like never before. That's how it's going to happen tonight. I said, that's how it's going to happen tonight. But you take the first step. You turn away from all those things that have brought the calamity and the suffering in your life. You turn away from your sin and you turn to the Savior and say, Jesus is my Savior. He will forgive you. He will change your life. Say, Lord, I come with all my heart, all my soul, all my mind. I've decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. And just come out of darkness tonight. Come out of sin tonight. Come out of your transgression tonight. Come out of that gang tonight. Come out of those crimes tonight. Say, Lord, I come. He will receive you. He will put salvation in your soul. Joy in your soul. Forgiveness in your life. And then after that, the rain of miracles will begin to fall. Are you ready there? I said, are you ready there? Heads bowed and eyes closed. The time of the latter rain. The season of the latter rain. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. You're going to take the first step now. You're turning away from everything that has withheld the latter rain from falling upon your life. You're turning away from everything that has stopped the showers of blessing. blessing from coming upon your life. It's about the nice closed. If you say, I'm coming out of darkness, praise the Lord. I'm coming out of my sin. Praise the Lord. I'm coming out of everything that has stopped the blessing of God for my life. Wherever you are, you raise up your hand. And the wonders will begin in your life. Wherever you are, I'm coming out. Out of darkness. Out of wickedness. Out of sin. Out of transgression. Out of evil. Out of disobedience. I'm coming out right now. I'm coming to God for forgiveness. I'm coming to Christ for salvation. Wherever you are, you raise up your hand. Where are you there? Where are you there? The Lord is looking for you. The Lord is waiting for you. Raise up that hand there. Raise up that hand there. Lord, I come out. Lord, I come out. Lord, I come out. All the evil seed I planted, I'm going to uproot everything right now. All the calamity manner, I'm coming out of this thing today. He says that I'm coming out of this thing today. All that bad, terrible covenant, I'm coming out of that covenant today. Wherever you are, you raise up your hand. All the association with the devil, association with Satan, Lord, I come out today. Where are you? Raise up that hand. Raise up that hand. As you raise up the hand, you stand up. You say, Lord, I stand for Christ now. I stand for Christ now. I surrender my life unto Christ. I surrender my life unto Christ. Raise up that hand and stand up. Raise up that hand and stand up. Satan will not get me back. Evil spirits will not get me back. That gang will not get me back. Crime will not get me back. Traditions of men will not get me back. Idolatry will not get me back. All those bad associations will not get me back. Lord, I come. Lord, I come. Lord, I come. Where are you? The Lord is waiting for you. Let the announcement of the latter rain be fulfilled in your life today. You raise up that hand, you stand up. As you stand up, open your mouth and tell the Lord. All the association in darkness, I get away from them. Lord, I come today. I'm coming out of the weakness of my life. Out of the wickedness of my life. Lord, forgive me. Lord, forgive me. Save me. Change my life. Give me your grace. I will not go back to them anymore. I come for the time of the showers of salvation. Showers of blessing. Showers of forgiveness. Showers of freedom. Showers of grace. Showers of your strength. Showers of your power. Lord, do it for me today. Save me, Lord. Save me, Lord. Save me, Lord. Change my life, Lord. I will not go back to those evil things anymore. In Jesus' name we pray. Keep up that hand and keep on standing up. You have taken the best step you ever took in your life. You've taken the best decision you ever took in your life. Forgiveness is coming now. Salvation is coming now. Blessing is coming upon your life now. Raise up that hand. Keep standing. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you tonight. We bless your name. You said, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And these have raised up their hands. Coming out of darkness, coming out of their sin, coming out of their evil, coming out of their crimes, coming out of that gang, coming out of those associations, and Lord, when they get back home, they'll burn all the things that associate them with evil and with Satan. According to your promise, forgive them in Jesus' name. Let the peace of God come to them. Let pardon, forgiveness come to them. And let the joy of salvation come to them. And the grace tonight live in newness of life. That victory to live in newness of life. Grant to every one of them now in Jesus' name. They believe and we believe that Jesus died for them on the cross of Calvary. And he said, it is finished. And I pray from the shedding of the blood of Jesus for them. I pray all their sins will be finished tonight in Jesus' name. And I pray, Lord, a new life will begin. Grace will come into their lives. Righteousness in their lives. Peace in their lives. And a new life in them in Jesus' name. Eternal life. Everlasting life. The life of Christ. Life of salvation. Now in each of them. Confirm it, Lord. Thank you for the answer. In Jesus' name we pray. You want a miracle, you want healing, deliverance, raise up your hand.
Then
you need the other hand where you have the challenge, the problem, the sickness. As you raise up your hand, mention that thing to God right now. Mention the name. You know the name. You know the problem. And then when I pray now, it's a confirmation. And whatever it is, after the prayer, when you hear the final amen, check up, it's done already. Mention the problem to God of you. Okay, let's pray then. Father, in Jesus' name, well, thank you tonight because there are showers here today. And there will be showers upon every life. Showers of blessing. Showers of healing. Showers of miracle. Showers of wonders. Showers of deliverance. Pour it upon everyone in Jesus' name. You are a loving God. You are not a partial God. You said you'll give the showers to every single blade, every single grass in the field. And so I pray for everyone that the showers of your miracle will come upon every soul, everyone here tonight, in Jesus' name. Your power will not fail on anyone. Your glory will not fail on anyone. The announcement, the proclamation of the showers will come upon everyone. But Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. What you did in other places, you are doing here. And we're asking, Lord, you confirm your miracle, confirm your healing, confirm your deliverance in every life here tonight in Jesus' name. The spirit of madness, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Epilepsy, come out in Jesus' name. I pray for every form of swelling. Swelling any part of the body, visible externally, or it is internal. I pray right now the hand of the Lord will touch you. Swelling be removed in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have long-standing sicknesses, incurable diseases. Tonight, Lord, I pray you stretch forth your healing hand. Incurable disease, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. All those cancer germs die off from their body right now. Cancer patient be healed in Jesus' name. I pray that tuberculosis will be healed right now. Be healed in Jesus' name. Also, be healed in Jesus' name. The problem of breathing, the asthma, I pray that you are touched or healed right now in Jesus' name. The hernia there in your body, I command, come out in Jesus' name. Whatever it is that is bringing that issue of blood in your life, I pray that that issue of blood will dry up right now. Be healed in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are deaf and dumb. I pray Lord, sound will come into your ears right now. And your voice will come out clear in Jesus' name. Deaf man, deaf woman, open the Lord, open those ears right now. Dumb tongue, speak out in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who are blind. The bandage of the devil will be removed. Cataract will vanish away. Glaucoma will vanish away. The dimness of sight will vanish away. Lord, touch those dim, blind eyes now. Open those eyes in Jesus' name. See clearly. Your vision to come back. Dimness to vanish away. Lord, confirm it for them in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have broken bones. I pray, Lord, mend those broken bones now. Strengthen those bones right now. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have stroke. And I pray that that stroke will vanish away. Stretch for that hand. Stretch for that leg. Be healed in Jesus' name. Paralysis, get out in Jesus' name. Lameness, vanish away in Jesus' name. Your spinal cord to receive strength. Your body structure to receive strength. If that will come out of that wheelchair, drop those crutches. You are made whole in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray that everywhere, outside the stadium, within the stadium, in every section, every pavilion, manifest your power. Manifest that deliverance. Manifest that healing. Receive your miracle in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The showers have come down. Showers of healing. Showers of wonders. Showers of deliverance. Confirm it in every life. In Jesus' name I pray. It is done. I said it is done. I said it is done. Check up. You see the miracle there.
It has happened. I say it has happened. Tonight, check up right there now. Please, as you see it, don't say praise the Lord. We are going to listen to some striking ones immediately now. Blind eyes have been opened. We want to hear the shout of praise the Lord. By my left hand side, let them be bringing them out. Please, let's be quick. Let's be quick. Please, once you have interviewed them and it is real, please just give me a sign. You bring them to the front. Where's the microphone?
I do. We're not anywhere.
Available right there. Anyone there, quickly. Let them come quickly. Let's be fast. Give her the microphone.
Praise the Lord.
Is that praise, you can say hallelujah?
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank God.
What is your name?
My name is Mary Odessi.
Yes.
I get better since last year. As in, if I go to scan, they tell me that there's no baby inside. But my feeling, I know I'm pregnant. Just now, I heard that they are doing saying Ogbe Stadium. That's why I just said, okay, let me just come. So come and receive my healing. I'll be going over everywhere. There's no solution. You tell me, say, is this? There's no tell me, is that? I was just walking normal. Who see me don't have that I'm pregnant? But just now, when daddy was just praying. If you have faith, believe. I don't believe. I just see my for my back. Something don't move. It's on my front. I just surprised. That's not beside what I can't call yours now. I surprised that praise the Lord. I was surprised.
You will deliver and come and give your testimony. That movement is a movement by the power of the Lord. Let's give a clap offering to Jesus. The next person, quick. The next person.
My name is Mrs. Ndubisi Francisca. Today, I am so grateful to God. I thank God for what He has done for me this evening.
Go ahead.
I couldn't believe it with my eyes. Yesterday, this morning, I went to school this morning. As I was conducting exam, my stomach was paining me seriously before I was having appendicitis. Later, the thing will come up. Later, it will go down. It will come up. It will go down. At the end of it, I was scared. I said, God, I don't want this thing to burst in my stomach. I don't really know. But I don't want it, please. This morning, I was conducting an exam in the school. The thing started again. Oh, my stomach. It was like they were using something that is needle to pierce my stomach. I said, okay, I have to send the nanny. I said, please help me to buy food. She bought food for me. I ate.
When I came out, at the end of it,
I still came back. The thing was still paining me. When I came here this evening, as Daddy was praying, I said, God, my own miracle, I must receive it this night. As I laid my hand on my stomach, he said, if anywhere that is disturbing, that we should lay our hand. I laid my hand on my stomach. At the end of it, behold, this evening, after the prayers, I was still praying. I said, God, you are going to show me. Because everywhere, both my waist here, all of them, it was like as if they put heavy stone on me. But today, this evening, God has done it. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. That appendicitis is gone in Jesus' name.
It's
gone. Let's give a clap of intro to Jesus. The next. Clap for Jesus. You are healed. Your name?
Praise the Lord. My name is Favor Tochuku. I'm from Unibank. LT1. I want to bless the name of the Lord for what He did to me. By the grace of God, I'm saved. Yesterday, the LGBT leader told us I would be coming here for decoration. I was like, God, my hand and my leg was paining me. I don't even know where this mysterious hand pain and leg pain came from. I just told Him bluntly that I'm not going to come, but I'll come for the program by 4. When I went to class, that yesterday evening, I wanted to wash some clothes, but I could not. My hand was seriously paining me. I was like, God, where did this hand pain come from? I just had to rinse the cloth and spread the cloth like that. So after my first class this morning, I decided, let me just rush down here and decorate the house of God. And after that, God will richly bless me. So when I came here in the morning, I was decorating. When I was cleaning pastor's chair, my hand was seriously paining me. The girl by my side, virtue, she was like, give me, let me help you to clean pastor's chair. I was like, no, I'm going to clean the pastor's chair where the man of God is going to sit down. And after this thing, this hand and leg pain is going to be gone. I even had to take off my shoes when I was cleaning the altar. The hand was still seriously paining me. I said, no, as I'm cleaning the altar of the man of God, he's going to stand and preach the word. God is seriously going to bless me.
What happened now?
And when the prayer was going on, he told us to lay our hands where it was paining us. I laid my hands on my hand. I was like, what about my leg? So I just had to lay my hands on my head. I said, from the whole of my body, God is going to heal me. But now I can't find the hand pain and leg pain. Praise the Lord.
Let's clap for the Lord. The next.
My name is Sylvester Agbede. Sylvester Grace. The thing when God do for me for this evening now, this speaking, it don't reach 4 years. Now when he blessed, they do one. As a pastor, they measure blessing, they pray. Now so the beginning just fall for grand. All the hand when they pay and the 2 hands, all is just finished. Nothing again.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. Praise the Lord. The Lord has healed him. Young man, you are free. You are healed. No more epilepsy. Let's clap for Jesus. Next, quickly. Say thank you, Jesus.
We will see Jesus.
Go ahead. Your name?
Okay. My name is Maria. Mario Boke. What did God do for me this night? My God, that is God. This is called miracle of God. This is my leg. Now, so they walk like small picking where they learn how to walk. As I call here, I say, I don't go because people plenty, I go for. Since when I come here and I sit down, my body are not gole. In fact, all my body, where not the feet talk, and not the feet waka. All my body, be like say, they don't remove it. All the old sickness, they don't remove it. God don't remove it.
Don't go.
I don't go. I don't the job.
See, mama, they waka.
Hey, this is called miracle.
Praise the Lord.
No, sir, when I'm on you, so
Mama, wakame we see you.
Wakame.
Praise the Lord.
No,
Mama, you are healed.